morning, church. Happy Sunday. I hope you are doing well and staying safe and healthy. I know this is a little bit weird, but I hope that you would just open up your hearts and just prepare your hearts for worship today. And we're going to be singing two songs together, so if you could just follow the lyrics on the screen and just open your heart, close your eyes, and just lift up your hands and worship the Lord. Before we do that, let's just open up in prayer. So bow your heads and close your eyes with me. Jesus, thank you so much for this time. We thank you for this opportunity of worship. We thank you that you have blessed us this entire week, that you have keeping us safe and healthy, and that you allow us the opportunity to be able to glorify your name. Dear God, I pray that everyone who is listening today, God, would just open up their hearts and their minds and their souls to prepare their hearts for worship, and later to prepare their hearts for listening of your word. Be with us today and allow us to just be filled with your presence and your joy and your hope and your love. In the name of Jesus we pray. Boundless grace.
Well, praise the Lord. Thank you for joining the Impact Christian Church of Rosemead online service this morning. It's great to be with you all. We just started this new year, and I think it's very important for all of us to look at the foundation of our life, whether it is solid or not. Because the Bible tells us that there will be many more shakings going to happen. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 27 through 26 through 27, it says that in the last days, whatever can be shaken will be shaken. So that only those things that cannot be shaken will remain. For our scriptures today, let us read the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 36 through 39. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, "Men and brethren, what shall we do?" Then Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized. Let every one of you be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is to you and to your children and to all who are far off, as many as the Lord our God will call." Let us pray, bow our hearts before we continue on. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray that your message will be planted in our hearts today. Speak through my mouth so that your words will be explained and spoken and delivered in a simple way and yet bring transformation in our lives, so that we can have a solid foundation in you and our life will not be shaken. Lord, we thank you so much. We worship you. We give you praise. I love you, Jesus. In your name I pray. Amen. Well, I want to title my message today, The Firm Foundation. Hallelujah. My dear friends, we really need to look at our life's foundation as we continue our life's journey this year, and yes, in the years ahead. I want us to listen what Jesus said in Luke chapter 6, verses 47 through 49. It says, "I will show you what someone is like who comes to me, listens to my words, and acts on them. That one is like a person building a house who dug deeply and laid the foundation on the rock. When the flood came, the river burst against that house but could not shake it because it had been well built. But the one who listens and does not act is like a person who built a house on the ground without a foundation. When the river burst against it, it collapsed at once and was completely destroyed." So Jesus said, this is the man, the one that has a strong foundation. They dug deep and built their foundation well. It says in this scripture, it's not if the flood comes, no. But it says when the flood comes, because it's not like if, or maybe happened, maybe not, but it says when the floods came, the flood means like the shaking or the problems come. It shows that these shakings, no matter we are ready or not, will come eventually. But if we have a strong foundation, a firm and solid foundation, those shaking will not destroy us. It will come into our lives, but will not destroy our lives. Hallelujah. So, from the scripture readings today in Acts chapter 2, verses 36 through 39, we learn there are two important foundations, two important things that we really need to have the firm and solid foundation in our lives. First of all, is in verse 36, it says that God has made Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. See, the first firm foundation, the first thing that we must have to have a strong foundation is that we must make Jesus Christ the Lord of our life. Because the Lord Jesus Christ is the only strong, true foundation. He is the only one. And remember, the Apostle Paul affirms this in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 11. It says that no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, He is the rock of ages that never changes. Hallelujah. He's the rock that never moves, that's so solid, on which we can build our life on this earth. Everything in the world changes. But the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8, Jesus Christ never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So when Peter preached this message in Acts chapter 2, verse 36 through 39 that we just read a while ago, he was actually preaching about the good news or the gospel that God sent His only Son. God sent His only begotten Son to die for our sins. In other words, God sent Jesus. Jesus came, He was sent by God to redeem us from sins. The core message of the gospel is this, that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, as Romans 3:23 says. And God, who is so rich in mercy, and because of His great love with which He loved us, He died for us, it says in Romans chapter 5, verse 8. While we were yet sinners, God demonstrated His love toward us, that Christ died for us. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. That's the core of the message of the gospel, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So no matter what we do outside the redemption work of Jesus Christ, we are still sinner. Well, some are good sinners, some are bad sinners, but we are still all sinners. And the Bible says in Romans 6:23 that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus. So no matter how hard we try, we are always short of the glory of God. Because no matter how much efforts we put, we always, during our lifetime, would fail to fulfill the commandments, the requirements of God's law. So, you know, the question is just like, how many times for you to, you know, sin for you not to go to, you know, heaven? Basically zero. It's gotta be perfect. So our good deeds, our good works, will not be good enough. But Jesus Christ did it for us. So no matter how hard we try, we will fail God. We will fail to fulfill or to obey the commandments of God once in our life. As James 2:10 says, "For whoever breaks one commandment is guilty of them all." But my dear friends, I have good news that God loves us so much that He did it for us so that we can have eternal life and live with Him forever. That's why the Bible says a while ago, I read it in Romans 5 verse 8, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Even when you didn't think of God, even if you didn't think about Christ, about Jesus, He died for you. He loves you. What an amazing and wonderful good news. Hallelujah. I'm not talking about religion here. I'm talking about the relationship with God through Jesus Christ. Jesus said in John chapter 14, verse 6, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father but by me." So it's so clear that Jesus is the only way to salvation, to eternal salvation, eternal life in heaven. In fact, in the book of Acts, if you continue on to read through chapter 4, verse 12, the Apostle Peter goes on to say that nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. So my friend, I'm not talking about an ideology or a religion. No, I'm talking about having a living relationship with God through Jesus Christ. I'm talking about that eternal salvation, going to heaven, which can only be found by accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior by faith in the sacrifice that Jesus did on the cross. Jesus already died for us. He already fulfills all the requirements of the law for us. All we need to do is by faith receive His sacrifice, His redemption work on the cross. So Jesus Christ is the first, is the solid, firm foundation. Hallelujah. The second thing that we need to do in order to have that firm foundation in our life is that we need to be God's words. We need to be the doer of God's words. In verse 37, when these people heard the message that Peter preached, they said, "Men and brethren, what shall we do?" Hallelujah. It means we need to be a doer of God's words. Hallelujah. Not just a listener, in order to have that firm foundation in our life. Dear my dear friends, accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior is just the beginning of building a strong and solid and firm foundation in Christ. It's just the beginning. It's not the end. So we need to continue building by being a doer of God's word. Since this is a lifelong journey, my friend, we need to understand that it's essential to continue growing in the Lord by being a doer and by being obedient to God's words. You know, it's interesting that the Bible uses the word know many times, because you cannot know, you cannot do something that you do not know. See, that's why it's important to be the doers of God. But before being a doer of God, you need to know what to do. See, that's why the Bible uses the word know many times. And the word know that it's used in the Bible in its original language is gnosko, which means to know by experience. To know by experience. So the analogy that is used there is to know in terms of the relationship between husband and wife. As in any marriage, it takes time to really know each other fully. You know, I've been married for more than 20 some years. I still really don't know my wife fully in a sense. I know what she likes, but I really don't know fully. Sometimes, you know, I misunderstand what she wanted me to do. So it takes time to know fully somebody that you love. It takes time. The same thing with our Christian walk with the Lord. We need to know Christ more every day. Hallelujah. So the same thing with our walk with the Lord, as I said, that, you know, in fact, the Apostle Paul prayer in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18, and chapter 3, verse 19, he said this, his prayer says that you may know, see that word know again, what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power? And chapter 3, verse 19 says, and to know the love of Christ, which passes all knowledge. Hallelujah. Well, we need to take time to know him by three things, my friend. First of all, is by reading God's words daily. It says in Psalm chapter 1, verse 2, his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. So, being the doer of God, or knowing God, we can know him by reading his words daily. I can never forget how much I love the word of God since I, you know, accepted Jesus into my heart. I just, you know, read and read. It's just like I just eat the word like that. It's so beautiful. And many times the words of God give me insight and give me understanding. And it's just wonderful. That's why if you have accepted Jesus Christ, one characteristic is that you love to read the word of God. It says there that his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. Hallelujah. Reading God's words every day will help us know more about God and about what he wants. About, you know, it will help us also to know the desires of God in our life. And as you read the word of God, the Bible, allow the Holy Spirit to give you understanding and you know, not just read, but also learn to dig into his words. If you don't understand, pray and get some commentaries, you know, Bible commentaries that were written by spirit-filled men and then people who love God. Read them and use the commentaries, and it's important. And also pray so that the Holy Spirit will also give you understanding, all right? Learn to know God more intimately in your spirit, not just through your mind, because sometimes our minds is limited. So you need to dig more and pray, ask the Lord to teach you his words so that you can love him more. Hallelujah. My friend, the word of God is so powerful. And when you read the word of God, the Bible says in Psalm 119, verse 105, that your word is a lamp unto my path and a light unto my feet. A lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So, my dear friends, it's so important to read the Word of God in our lives daily so that we can have that strong and firm foundation. The second thing that you can do to be, to know the Word of God, to have the foundation, that firm foundation, is by prayer. Hallelujah. It says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17, the Apostle Paul says this, pray without ceasing. In other words, prayer is not just about asking things from God, but more than that is that prayer is a communication with God. It's a two-way communication with God. Nothing wrong by asking Him, like, you know, what you need. No, no, if you have any need, it's nothing wrong to bring it up to the Lord. But move on than just asking. More than asking, you learn to communicate with God and let Him speak to you. Hallelujah. Remember, my friend, this is a love relationship. A love relationship that is so pure, so holy, so marvelous, so noble, so just, so lovely, so virtuous, so praiseworthy. Jesus is our lover. Jesus Christ is, you know, He is everything. He's so wonderful. So this is a love relationship. Let Him learn, and learn to let Him talk and speak to you. Listen, learn to listen to His small, gentle voice in your spirit by doing three things. First, meditating in His words and allowing His words to dwell in us. John chapter 15, verse 7 says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done to you. So meditate upon His word and allow His words to abide in you. Second, meditate upon the beauty of the Lord. Psalm 27 verse 4 says, one thing have I desired of the Lord that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in His temple. Isn't that beautiful? Remember, it's a love relationship. Hallelujah. Third, by being aware of His continuous presence in our life. Colossians chapter 3 verse 3 says that your life is hidden in Him and He is in you. So this is so important to cultivate in our lives. Hallelujah. Besides that, the third point that I want to mention to you is this. We can know Him by obeying His words. James 1:22 says that be the doer of the word, not just hearer only. My friend, after Peter, in this scriptures that we read, our main scripture, when Peter preached the gospel, the people who heard him were cut to their heart. In other words, the Holy Spirit brought conviction in their heart and they were convicted of their sins. When people asked the apostle what to do, the apostle Peter answered them, repent, be baptized, and be filled with the Holy Spirit. So in our spiritual journey, for us to have that firm and solid foundation, we must cultivate that conviction of the Holy Spirit in our lives in order that we can be sensitive to His voice and the prompting of His voice in our life. Remember that the Holy Spirit brings conviction that leads to repentance. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 10 says, godly sorrow produces repentance leading to salvation. Not accusation that makes us feel condemned, because there's no more condemnation for those who are in Christ. Romans chapter 8, verse 1 says that. In other words, we need to learn to repent as soon as we know that we make mistakes. When we fall in sin, go back to the Lord immediately confess your sins and believe by faith that God has forgiven and cleansed you from your sins. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9 says that God is faithful and just, that if we confess our sin, He will forgive us and cleanse us from all our sins. Because if your heart condemns you, remember that God knows our heart better than we know ourselves. 1 John 3:20 says that. So when you've confessed your sin, believe that God has forgiven you. All right? Praise God. And as we begin to determine in our hearts to obey His words, my friend, I believe that we will continue to grow in His love and in His grace. And by doing so, our foundation will become firm, strong, and solid. In closing, let me say this. Remember that this is a lifelong journey. So rest assured that Jesus loves us so much. He loves us so much. Learn to enjoy His love every day and continue to love Him more and more each day. Get blended in the church of body believers where you can grow spiritually, become mature in the Lord. Keep loving Jesus. And let me tell you, my friend, love is a powerful force, because the more we love Jesus, the more we will be changed into His likeness, so that His love and power may flow through our lives, touching those around us who need to experience the reality of His life. May this song be our prayer as we love Jesus more deeply in every moment of the day. It says this song, to be like Jesus, to be like Jesus. All I ask, just to be like Him. All through life's journey, from earth to glory, all I ask, just to be like Him. Continue to love Him as you continue to build your life and to grow in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank You for Your words today. I pray that if anyone who is listening right now, who's never accepted You as his or her Lord and Savior, I pray that that person, whoever he or she is, will open their hearts and invite You to come into their life. Father, I thank You so much for the wonders and the beauty of Your words today. We love You, Jesus. In Jesus' name, I commit everyone who's listening today in Your hands. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Oh, just one word, You calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Oh, just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing. Praise the name that makes a way. Well, praise the Lord. I'm sure you're blessed by the Word of God today. Let us close our online service today in prayer. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you so much that your Word is spoken today. I pray that your Word will be planted deep in the hearts of your people and bring forth much fruits for your kingdom and for the glory of your name. May your blessings be upon your people right now, Father. May the peace of God our Father and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of us from now until Jesus comes again. Everyone who loves the Lord says, Amen.